What's going on everybody, this is Kart and I'm back with a new video. But first off, I would like to thank you, my fellow followers. We've reached together the 500 mark and I hope that we will continue to grow together as a community in this amazing journey. So let's go to 1K. So today we'll discover how to create a really cool looking and realistic glass shader inside Maya with the power of Arnold Render. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea and let's roll the intro.
So guys, the first thing we need to make this realistic glass shader is an interesting model. So if you are looking for some cool 3D models, CGTrader.com is a cool website to know. Let's search for a badass model, like a samurai for example. Let's download this model, as it has immediately grabbed my attention. Okay then, I've just fired up Maya, and I've set up a basic loop dev scene with the downloaded model. If we look a moment to the setup of the scene, it's pretty basic. We've got an HDRI, a fill light on the right, a key light on the left to accentuate the direction of the global composition, and a rim light, and of course a backdrop. For the camera, I've chosen an 80mm focal length. The camera is set up with a low angle shot to make the figurine more imposing and bold. If I open the outliner, you can see that everything is clean and tidy. It's important to have everything well organized if you work in production with a team. So it's good to get into this habit early on. Okay, so let's begin by creating an AE standard surface. Let's rename it properly and also don't forget the shader engine too. Now we can assign it to the model. Let's launch the IPR to see what we've got. Let's set up our basic glass shader. For the base color, let's input a mid-gray value. It's not mandatory with refraction shader because it will not be used. But later on, I will disable transmission to see better what I will be doing. Okay, now for the specular roughness, let's put a high value because I want to do an old glass with imperfection. So something like 0.65 will be okay. And for the IR, 1.55. Let's refresh the IPR. Sweet. Now let's add the transmission, weight to 1. Don't forget to unflag the opaque checkbox, as it is a transparent shader. So go to in the attribute editor and then in the shape tab. Under the Arnold tab, you will find it. Okay, now let's add a cut on top of everything. Let's set the cut weight to around 0.2, the roughness to a really low value, almost 0, and the IR to 1.2. Nice. Now we will use a texture to drive our roughness and bump. It will add some surface imperfection and details to make the shader more realistic. Okay, let's create a fine node, select our texture and change the color space to raw because it's a grayscale scalar map. Now we can create a quick triplanar node to avoid creating UVs on the model. Let's connect it like this and rename the node properly. Now let's check the map in the IPR in solo mode. The scale is way too small, so let's tweak it a bit. Okay, sweet. We open the details panel in the IPR. We can control the luminescence value. It will determine the value of the roughness in the shader.
Hey you, I know you are watching my video and I know you are not subscribed yet. It's literally so easy, just go down there and boom, press subscribe. So like this video, comment and hit the subscribe button. Now back to this sweet shader.
To remap the value, we can use an AE range node. Let's plug it in the middle like this and rename it. In the AE range node properties, let's lower the output max and increase the contrast. Yeah, pretty neat. Now let's add another level of detail. Let's create the bump map based on our roughness map. Like this, only one single map will drive everything. If you change it, you will have a totally different result. Let's add an AE range to remap the value and plug it in the bump mapping slot of the shader. Let's decrease the bump value to 0.05. We need to be subtle here. Let's refresh the IPR to see what we've got. Okay, let's create a reverse node before the high range node to invert the bump. Sweet. Let's reintroduce our transmission. I've deactivated temporarily to see what I was doing. Now we create variations in the transmittance color. To do so, let's take the roughness, reverse it, and plug it in the transmission color input. Yeah, nice. Let's put back the transmission weight to 1. Back to the IE range node of the bump. I forgot to change the value here to make the bump value less contrasty. Okay, better. Next step, let's add a level of dirt above all. Let's create another IE standard surface and an IE mix shader to mix everything together. Now we can change the base color of the dirt to something dark brownish and the specular roughness value to 0.65. Now let's add our dirt shader to the mix shader on shader 2. Shader 2 will be always the shader on top. Yeah, I know, Arnold logic. Now let's create another IE standard surface. This one is temporary, just to see better what we are doing here. As you can see, if the weight is equal to 1, it takes only the shader 2, aka our dirt, and vice versa. Now we want to add an IE ambient occlusion to drive the max, as the dirt is present mainly in the occluded areas, and plug it like this. Now let's tweak the value of the AO. Nice. Now to add complexity, let's add an IE noise and plug it into the black input of the AO node. Let's tweak it a bit. Okay, sweet. Now let's add another IE range to boost the output value. So let's increase the output max value and the contrast value. Pretty sweet. Once again, let's rename the nodes. Now we can replug our glass shader into the mix shader node and delete our temporary shader. Now let's check the result in the IPR once again. Nice. One last thing, to add the last bit of realism, let's add some dispersion aberration into the transmission, a really low value, like 15. And boom, the final result. Really, really nice. What do you think, guys? This is a really cool way of doing some realistic old glass shaders.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.